howtobackupoutlook.com email. Hi everyone, Leo Notendom here for askleo.com. Just a reminder, every video has an article. Every article has a video. You're looking at the video and you'll find the article associated with this one at askleo.com/4483. Here's the question. How do I back up the email I have hosted on outlook.com? Contacts too. Most people don't back up their outlook.com accounts. All their email is stored in exactly and only one place, in that account stored on Microsoft's online servers. When that account is hacked or lost for any reason, all that email disappears, often forever. Remember, if it's in only one place, it's not backed up. To avoid the possibility of losing everything backing up your Outlook.com account, or to be fair, any online email account, is critical. I'll show you how. If your email is stored in one and only one place, in other words, Microsoft's servers here, you need to make a copy somewhere else. The simplest way is to use your PC. Using an email program running on your PC downloads your email to your PC. Keeping that email on your PC creates a second copy of your email. In fact, if you're backing up your PC regularly, as you should be, you'll be creating additional backups of the email downloaded to it. Unfortunately, the built-in email programs, confusingly now also called Outlook, will no longer work for this, as they are more like interfaces to the online account rather than a more traditional download to your computer email program. There are many different email programs out there that could be used. Examples include Thunderbird, Microsoft's own Outlook Classic, EM Client, Apple Mail, and many, many others. I'll show you how to do this using Thunderbird. Now, Thunderbird is a free, powerful, open-source email client. I prefer Thunderbird for a variety of reasons, but it can be a little more daunting to set up. I have an article and a video, Back Up Your Email Using Thunderbird, that's got fairly complete step-by-step instructions for both email and contacts. I'll walk you through the steps. Download and install Thunderbird. Well, I already did that. We are looking at Thunderbird running on my PC without any email accounts configured. Which means, of course, set up another account, email. The email address that I want to use is askleoexample@hotmail.com. Remember, this makes it an Outlook.com account. It's serviced by the Microsoft email system, which includes Outlook.com, Hotmail.com, WebTV.com, Live.com, a bunch of different Microsoft-provided email addresses. Click on Continue. Looking up the configuration, yep, it's got interesting information here. We'll use IMAP. We'll go ahead and hit Continue. And we're done. The unable to find connected services here simply means that there were no address books, there were no calendars that Thunderbird knows how to pull in. All we have is email. I'll click Continue. We're not going to do anything else. We'll click on Finish. And now if I take a look at my inbox, this account, which is essentially a spam magnet, is full of email that is now duplicated on my PC. Now, there's one more thing that I kind of suggest you do with Thunderbird. This is kind of a Thunderbird-specific thing, and that is this. I'm hitting the Alt key so that the menu bar is displayed, clicking on File, clicking on Offline, and then there it says download/sync now. I'm going to have it download and or sync all the mail messages, and it just happens to send any unsent messages if there are any. The issue is this. Even when configured this way, Thunderbird will download mail, but it may not download all of it until you explicitly tell it to. Doing this periodically ensures that all of the email in all of your folders from Outlook.com will be replicated to your PC. Now, to back up your Outlook.com contacts, that's a pain. Contacts in general are a pain industry-wide. Again, this article and video, back up your email using Thunderbird, has an overview of the steps, but the bottom line is simply this. At Outlook.com, you will explicitly and manually export your contacts and save them, probably to a .csv file, somewhere on your PC. I'm not going to show you importing them because we're not trying to do that. We're not trying to move our base of operations. We're just trying to keep a backup of the information that we're using in Outlook.com. So by saving that CSV file somewhere on your PC, you've got a copy. And now that your PC is, of course, being backed up, that file is being backed up as well. Like I said, contacts remain a mess industry-wide. Aside from a few rather obvious fields, like name and email address and so on, there's really no standardization of what's included in a contact. That's one reason there's no consistent synchronization between mail programs and online services. Additional information, like notes and pictures and more detailed fields, supported by one may or may not be recognized by another. Transferring contacts from one program or service to another almost always involves some frustrating amount of data loss. Since our goal here is backing up, then the information should be preserved if we're going to restore it to the same program. All right, question you may have at this point is, where is my email? Well, again, depending on which email program you happen to use, it can be in different places, but I will show you where that is in Thunderbird. Like I said, here we are in Thunderbird. We've got the email account set up. We've got email downloaded to it, and we've ensured that everything's been synchronized down to the PC. I'm going to close that. I'm going to open up Windows File Explorer, and because I know what it is ahead of time, I'm going to go to c:\users/%username, which will be automatically replaced by the username for your current account. appdata/roaming/thunderbird/profiles. These randomly named folders are where Thunderbird stores your email. We can take a look at the one that is dated the 13th today, the most recent one. We can dive into it and we can see all sorts of things here. If we take a look at IMAP Mail, here is the account that we just created, right? The Outlook.Office 365. There's an older one because I had an older account that I removed prior to this. This is the newer account. In here are the folders that contain the actual email and information associated with that account. If you're going to back something up, it's this profiles folder that you want to make sure gets backed up. If you're backing up your entire computer, of course, you don't have to worry about that because this will be included. But that's where Thunderbird stores your email. Other email programs, like I said, will be different. Now, I said we don't necessarily want to move our base of operations. The assumption here has been that you're backing up Outlook.com, but you're going to continue to use Outlook.com for your day-to-day email interaction. You don't have to. There's nothing wrong with actually using the desktop email program you just installed to access your email if you like. You might find it more responsive or feature-rich than the online Outlook.com interface. It could be a nice way to have a single point of access to multiple email accounts. The connection we've made to download your email will also upload any email you send into your sent email folder online. In fact, using your desktop email program is a good way to ensure that it's run every so often, just to make sure that your email gets backed up. Please, back up your Outlook.com email. Whether it be Thunderbird or some other desktop email program, it's the only way to protect yourself from losing everything in it, should it ever be lost or compromised. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, or that article I talked about, visit askleo.com/4483. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.